hope you're happy. This is
it's an great hour from now.
And please recite after me. May Adonai bless you and protect you.
May God
bless you and protect you.
May God show you favor.
May God show you favor.
I beg you guys to see her.
Thank you.
may be seated. Ruchim Habayim B'Shem Adonai. May those who enter be blessed in the name of God. May the one who is supreme in power, in blessing, and glory bless this Chatan Jordan and this Kala Courtney. We welcome you with this moment. Your hopes are being fulfilled. This moment is a merging of two paths of lives into one. Ruchim Habayim, we welcome you to a loving partnership. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen. And now you recite Amen.
Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kedushanu b'mitzvasa v'tzivanu al harayot v'asar lanu es ha'arusa v'yitar lanu es ha'nisu v'es lanu es yidei chupa v'kidushin Baruch atah Adonai mekadosh am Yisrael al yidei chupa v'kidushin. Praised are you, Adonai, our God, who rules the universe, whose mitzvot add holiness to our lives, and whose will guides us. Even in the most intimate of our relationships, praised are you, Adonai, our God, who sanctifies the people Israel with chuppah, the wedding canopy, and kedushin, the sacred wedding tradition. And the rings. That's one.
Okay.
Let's see if I can figure out which one's which. In the Jewish tradition, the ring, besides the obvious symbolism of it, it also represents a circle, the continuity, the eternity of life. And there's a tradition that many people have to have a plain ring without diamonds. And this is so that everybody is clear. The ring represents many things for many people. And this way, when you have different kinds of stones, people don't know what was given, what wasn't, what the value is. Here, everybody's clear. When it comes to a metal, you can weigh it, you know the value. Please repeat after me. Hare.
Hare.
Look at her. At.
At.
Mekudeshet.
Mekudeshet.
Li.
Li.
Bitabat.
Bitabat.
Zo.
Zo.
Kidat.
Kidat.
Moshe.
Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
By this ring.
By this ring.
You are consecrated to me.
You are consecrated to me.
As my wife.
As my wife.
In accordance.
In accordance.
With the laws of Moses.
With the laws of Moses.
And the people of Israel.
And the people of Israel.
Hare At.
Hare At.
Mikudesh Li.
Mikudesh Li.
V'tabat Zo.
V'tabat Zo.
Kedat.
Kedat.
Moshe.
Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
By this ring.
By this ring.
You are consecrated to me.
You are consecrated to me.
As my husband.
As my husband.
In accordance.
In accordance.
With the laws.
With the laws.
Of Moses.
Of Moses.
And the people of Israel.
And the people of Israel.
And in this special month of Elul, as we proceed towards Rosh Hashanah, there's a line that's said referring to God. But it's also a beautiful line for a groom and a bride. Ani ledodi vedodi li. I am my beloved's and my beloved is mine. Now, you can go to the ring. Simane kechotam alibecha, kechotam alzreecha. Let me be a seal upon your heart, like the seal upon your hand. And that's from the Song of Songs. We now celebrate the second part of the ceremony, the Nisuin. The blessings are about to we are about to recite express our gratitude to God for the miracle of life in general, and the sanctity of married life in particular, because there are seven blessings in all. They have come to be known simply as the Sheva Brachot, the seven blessings. In our tradition, seven carries special significance. It is a number of wholeness and holiness. It is a number of Shabbat, as the Shabbat goes out, the seventh day, and thus the number of peace. May the Sheva Brachot confer blessings on each day of every week of Jordan and Courtney's life together. But before we do that, I just wanted to take a moment to talk about them for a little bit. I got to meet them at a Starbucks, because that's what we do in Manhattan. And you know, we went through the usual you know, questions and, you know, what are we gonna do, exactly how are we gonna do it? And then we started schmoozing a little. And we started schmoozing about values. We started schmoozing about relationships. We started schmoozing about Torah study. And I got the impression from the both of them that this is a solid couple. This is a couple that are curious, that want to learn from each other, that have been together, that have gotten to know each other, and want to build a genuine, beautiful home. And when I asked them what in particular they think of when they think of each other in terms of positive things. So Jordan, talking of Courtney, said she was intuitive and funny. Courtney said of Jordan, she thought of stability and her best friend. And I'm sure there are many other adjectives, but I think that this says some of the foundation that we have here that we're building on. And now we have the big cut. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen. Amen. After each one, just say amen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, shehakol bara lechado.
Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, yotzer ha'adam. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Yaser Asadam B'Talma, B'Tzalom D'Mustaf Nisa, V'Yizkin Lo Mimenu B'Nyan Adayad. Baruch atah Adonai Yotzer Adam. Tzatzasi Tzatzagel HaKara, B'Kibitz B'nei Elosech B'Simcha, Baruch atah Adonai Mesameach Tzion B'Vaneha. Samach Tzamach Reim Ahuvim, Kisamecha Yitzircha B'Gan Eden Mikedem, Baruch atah Adonai Amen. And now I'll read a little English so you have an idea of what we're talking about. Praised are you, Adonai, our God, who rules the universe, who created joy and gladness, bride and groom, pleasure, song, delight, laughter, love, and harmony, peace and companionship. Adonai, our God, may there always be heard in the cities of Judah and the streets of Jerusalem, voices of joy and gladness, of happiness, voices of bride and groom, the jubilant voices of those joined in marriage under the chuppah, the voice of young people feasting and singing. Praised are you, Adonai, who causes the groom and bride to rejoice together. And we'll read the final one. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher baras asem b'simcha chasan v'kala asher baras asem b'simcha chasan v'kala gilarina dita v'chedva v'yachva v'sholom v'reyus meheira adonai leini shama bar Yehuda uvechutzas Yerushalayim kol chasan v'kol simcha kol chasan v'kol kala kol mitzvos chasanim v'chasam v'narim mishdei yeginasam baruch atah Adonai mesameach chasanim hakala. Amen. This is the beautiful ketubah that they picked out. And I'll spare you the Aramaic reading, but there is English on the bottom. So for those curious, the reason it's in Aramaic is because at the time that it was originally created, that was the language that people spoke. And so it's kind of funny because now we don't speak Aramaic, but we still have it in Aramaic. The groom and the bride undertake this pledge of love. They choose each other as friends according to the teachings of our ancestors who said, acquire a friend with whom you will learn, next to whom you will sleep, and in whom you will confide. They consecrate themselves to each other and will always be true to each other. They take on all the duties and rights of family members toward each other. They promise to lead a life of justice and of loving kindness in their family and community till the end, in accordance with the verse, let me be a seal upon your heart, like the seal upon your arm. The bride and the groom acknowledged the responsibilities of this covenant and solemnly accepted the obligations herein. This ketubah is valid and binding. Sounds very final. And we will conclude with the tradition that you're all familiar with, the breaking of the glass. And as I got to tell you guys, so I did a little research on this tradition, and there's a lot of different explanations about why we do it, you know, and the most well-known story is that we do it to remember the destruction of the temple and those that are less fortunate or who are suffering. But then you go a little bit further back and you go into the Talmud and you see a story of a rabbi who, it was his daughter's wedding, and people were getting a little too rowdy. And so he smashed a plate or whatever it was and he said, guys, you know, it's cool, but keep it in proportion here. But the real reason, when you go further back, is because of an ayin hara, which is that people fear some kind of evil spirit might come, the same way sometimes we might tie a rubber, you know, a red ribbon around our hand, or we might pull our hair when we sneeze, or whatever it is. That was actually the original reason. And whether people believe in it or not in modern times, it's come to be a beautiful tradition that we celebrate. And if you Google it, you'll see all kinds of explanations for it. But either way, this is the way we traditionally end a Jewish chuppah ceremony. Remember when you're ill. Wait a second. When Jordan does break the glass, we will all shout Mazel Tov. Go for it.
Mazel Tov!
Because our bride and groom are going to share their first official dance together as husband and wife.
When I woke up in the morning, love, sunshine hurts my eyes, and something with my morning love my mind. And I look at you. And the world's alright with me. Just one look at you. And I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Pick up our groom. Everybody get in there. Anyone that's been to the gym this year. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Bring them on down. One more time, everybody, hold hands and circle to the left. Everybody, hold hands and circle to the left. To our circles. Everybody hold hands and circle to the left.
Hold the future in your hand. Here I am, baby. feel good. I knew that I would not. So good, so good. I got to you. Wow, I feel nice. A sugar and spice. I feel.
All right, we're going to ask anyone to turn your attention out here for just a moment and lower your voices.
There we go.
Shh. Oh.
All right, Jim, we'll do
the buzz
together.
Yes, together.
Here we go.
Baruch atah Elohim melech olam hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
Jim, look here for the newspapers.
All right, guys, thank you, baby. I just wanna stop and thank you, baby. Oh, yes.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
Oh, now.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
It's like jelly.
Good evening. Diane and I want to welcome all of you to the celebration of Jordan and Courtney's marriage. When I last addressed most of you, it was almost 10 years ago at Jillian and Adam's wedding. Since then, we've lost some family members. My mother, Rosalind, her sister and everyone's Aunt Blanche, Courtney's maternal grandparents, and of course, the original Motzi man, Uncle Alvin. As you can see today, it took two Motzi men to fill his shoes. In addition, we lost some very dear friends who we will all miss and remember. On the bright side, however, our family has had incredible joy with the addition of four beautiful grandchildren. We are so proud of Rory, Hunter, Grant, and Sloan. Our venue tonight is the Montami Golf Club. Montami is a very special place in the hearts of Jordan's family. His grandparents, Gloria and Seymour Bidner, were members from the club's inception. His uncle Brad was bar mitzvahed here, and his aunt Elise was married here. And one of Jordan's first summer jobs was as a golf caddy here. As you can see, this place has special meaning to us. As most of you know, I usually prepare a speech that contains a poem, poking fun at the bride or the groom. Tonight is no different. However, what I really want to focus on is what Jordan's favorite comedian, George Carlin, would call the wedding process. Now, for a brief second, before any of you get a little uneasy and say to yourselves, what is he going to say next? Relax. I've been down this road before, and during the last week, there has not been an Alexander Haig moment wherein I can say I have everything under control. We are under a new administration. So I put on my game face, turned to my wife and girlfriend of 50 years, and said to her my best Donald Trump imitation. This is going to be an incredible, fantastic night, believe me. And I'm going to give them a huge toast. Being born in the middle isn't an easy thing. Both Diane and I sat on that very same swing. Jordan's situation had a different dynamic. Dealing with him was like trying to turn the Titanic. While all the kids in school liked a lunchbox as their tag, Jordan preferred his lunch in a brown paper bag. Riding the bus to school would prove a similar fate, as often we would see what Jordan had previously ate. The early years were very tough on my wife as Jordan continued to dole out much strife. The move to New Jersey didn't lessen his demeanor. In fact, it appeared that he was getting even meaner. He was a mathematical wizard, we certainly knew, But day in and day out, it was like taming a shrew. As the years clicked by, we noticed a change. He wasn't as needy and difficult, and we thought that was strange. He became independent, and he liked it that way, and sometimes he even listened to what we had to say. So Courtney, we told you, you have a tall task at hand, because Jordan always marches to his very own band. He is loyal and steadfast, a trait you can admire, but getting him to do things will test your desire. We're turning him over to you, but we want to be fair. Remember that caveat emptor means buyer beware. Thank you. I could have gone on for another 20 minutes. The events leading up to tonight aren't extraordinary, but they are turn-of-the-century, circa 2000, boy-meets-girl stuff when Jordan and Courtney first met as campers at Camp Towanda. 10 years later, they reconnected again, riding the subways of Manhattan. 2 more years passed, another chance encounter occurred on Fire Island. Thank you, Adam and Jillian. And as Courtney says, the rest is history. Now, both Courtney and Jordan are extremely hardworking. Courtney has a terrific job as a senior account executive at Valentino and travels the world. Jordan works for Blackstone and has more initials after his name than I could ever remember. Together, they are a formidable couple who are truly connected. If their unity as a couple was ever questioned or tested, the wedding process would reveal any chinks in the armor. As you can easily see in the splendor tonight, they survive and are stronger and better than ever. Courtney and Jordan, tonight is your night. And so I ask everyone, please raise your glasses and let's toast the newlyweds. We and our new president all wish you many, many, dozens and dozens, hundreds and hundreds, millions and millions and billions of happy years together.
Let's give a big round of applause. Gentlemen, come on out and join us on the dance floor.
I know you're still just a dream. Your eyes might be green for the newest that I've ever seen. Anyway, the star from the sky, pull your name from a hat. I promise you that, you'll be there. Before I'm too old to have that dream. To walk with you and watch you grow, and you know that you're there. And you'll be blessed, you'll have the best. I promise you that, pick the star from the sky, pull your name from a hat. I promise you that, I promise you that, take the star from the sky, pull your name from a hat. I promise you that, promise
you. Some superhero, some fairy tale. motion. I want to stop. Thank you, baby. I want to stop. Thank you, baby. Yes, I do. How sweet it is to be loved by you. It's so funny. How sweet it is to be loved by you. And I know it's gonna be
terrible affair. And when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way, then I look at you and the world's alright with me. I just one look at you and I know it's gone.